Thank you. it's like two people, woman they wear size D and the man they wear size 10. And what you're trying to do at that moment is merge a 10 into an 8. Now we know a man can't run an 8 if it's true to 10, and it will hurt. But over the course of time, it will work itself out, and that's what marriage is about. So I charge moms today, brother, nephew, I charge y'all today to move out the way and at least to become one, because that's going to be very important. And I charge my friends as well. Don't ever choose a side. Don't ever get in there. Don't even offer your best opinion unless you pray about it. And you'll sit by God and do it. Because this is important to the kingdom of heaven. Because marriage is that important. So that's a charge for moms today. That's a charge for siblings and nephews today. And for all the friends that are present. You may see it. Marriage is intended to join for life. And a relationship is so intimate and personal that it will change your whole being. You know, these are the things you talked about a few weeks ago, right? Because even though you have been friends for years and in a relationship and, you know, have shared a lot of things, but this is about to change everything. God is about to do something so magnificent that by tomorrow, we're going to be like, wow, we should have done this.
Amen.
Amen. From this time forward, we will belong entirely and only to one another. If either of you, for any reason, may not now be off and join your marriage, declare it now. If anyone here present knows the reason why these two now may not be joined in holy wedlock, declare it now, or forever hold your peace. I'm going to read the scripture. And I've heard the scripture many times where his life goes on the real side of his sin. And this is 1 Corinthians 13. Though I speak with the tongues of the men and angels, but have not love, I have become sounding brass or clanging cymbal. And though I have the gift of prophecy and understand all mysteries and all knowledge, and though I have all faith so that I can move mountains, but have not love, I have nothing. And though I bestow all my goods to feed the poor, and though I give my body to be burned, but have not love, it profits you nothing. Love, and this is important for all of us in this world. Love suffers long and is kind. Love does not envy. Love does not degrade itself. Love is not puffed up. Does not behave rudely. Does not seek its own. Does not provoke, thinks no evil. Does not rejoice in iniquity, but rejoice in the truth. In the truth. And let that be the foundation. Love bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, and endures all things. Love never fails. But whether they are prophecies, they will fail. Whether they are tongues, they will cease. Whether they are knowledge, they will also fade away. For we know in part and prophesy. But when that which is perfect is come, then that which is in part will be done away. And this is important for you, Stephen, when I see you, Stephen, and for you, Angela. When I was a child, I spoke as a child. I understood as a child. I thought as a child. But when I became a man, when I became a woman, I put away child's sins. For now I'm seeing in the mirror then, but then face to face. Now I know in part. But then I said, Lord, this is that I'm also known. And now by faith, hope, love, these three, but the greatest of these three is love. Now, you may face each other and we'll shut back a little bit. Thank you. relationship, to give yourself to Him in love and to work, to invite Him fully into your being, so He may fully know who you are, to cherish Him above all others, and to respect His individuality. I encourage Him to be Himself and to grow in all God intended for Him. Amen. This is important. This is my little sermon there for the day, right? This is important. Not just to say it, but to embody, to do it. And in Genesis, it talks about the man will cleave to his wife and the two shall become one flesh. This is very important in marriage. You know, we see a lot of marriages fail because there is a lot of people that have their own opinions. And sometimes us as individuals, we have our own opinions. But what God is saying today is that you two will now become one flesh, because it's very important. The Lord God created the heavens and the earth, and He said it is good. He divided the land from the sea, and He said it is good. He separated the light from the darkness, and He said it is good. He created the birds of the air, the fish of the sea, and the animals of the earth, and He said it is good. But see, when He made man, He said it is not good that a man should be alone. I will make him happy. Stephen, in Hebrew, word help me literally translate to second self. We don't hear that often in marriage ceremonies. The second self. This understanding is in part of meaning the two shall become one. In marriage, we will become absorbed into each other's aspirations, ambitions, ideals, dreams, and interests. And God crafted woman not from the man's head to rule over him, not from his feet for him to walk over her, but from his side to be equal with him and close to his heart to be cared for and protected. As Christian marriage exemplifies Christ's union to the church, I would share three foundation stones of this sacred union, and the first is consecration. Christ is the chief cornerstone, the head of the church, and the head of our lives. In a few moments, you will vow for God to keep this sacred covenant of marriage. Your marriage will achieve the deepest levels of joy and intimacy as you each consecrate your lives to the Lord. That's from consecration. Two, commitment. For anything to be accomplished, there must be commitment to the task. And then you gotta do everything y'all gotta do to make sure it works at all times. Therapy, counseling, fasting, praying, sitting, be quiet, read your word, all those different things. Nothing in the Bible ever comes easy. Committed love is authentic. Not about what you say, about what you do. Commitment is present in the good and of our times, when the sun is shining, when the storm clouds are moving. Today is coming to life. And the last, third thing, communication. Now we all have problems communicating. We do. I'm sure everybody in this room has a problem expressing themselves sometimes. But then it's not just like the word on that. So before, today it was just y'all's and a committed union. But after today, I will be husband and wife. So never take the words, I love you, for granted. Speak these words daily, not only in verbally, but through action. So not just in word, but in deed. Love is a verb. Consecration, commitment, and communication. These songs set in place, set in place, and you will build your life together on a strong foundation. Now, you all have your personal problems? Okay. I don't know if you got yours right.
I don't. name. This is my purpose.
Go ahead and vote.
So if you have to make symbol of this marriage. And you are giving the rings. The wedding rings are the outward and visible sign of the inward spiritual bond that unites this man and his soul in marriage. The symbol represents the unbroken and enduring bond of this marriage. Lord, bless these rings that have seen and as your gift will see, they may abide in your peace. Amen. Lie in the world, but not of the world. involves me. It is now my privilege, by the authority vested in me, as an ordained minister of the gospel, in accordance with the laws of the state of Massachusetts, I now pronounce you husband and wife. Thank you just for the marriage union that's about to take place, Lord. That every hand in this circle, every person in this building, I pray that your love transcends everything that they might be dealing with today, that they might know your love, Lord. Father, whatever mishaps could happen, we cancel those today in Jesus' name. And we pray that today would be a day filled with true love, Lord God. We thank you in advance. In Jesus' name.
Amen and amen.
just for the marriage union that's about to take place, Lord. That every hand in the circle, every person in this building, I pray that your love transcends everything that they might be dealing with today, that they might know your love, Lord. Father, whatever mishaps could happen, we cancel those today in Jesus' name. And we pray that today would be a day filled with true love, Lord God. We thank you in advance. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen and amen.
Just me, you can look. All right.